السلام عليكم.
وعليكم
وعليكم السلام.
السلام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Yeah, Day of a Muslim series number 7 we are discussing. We have seen when a Muslim wakes up from his bed, he should recite or read one dua, that is بسم الله
الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور.
Yes. Also, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. سبحان الله والحمد لله لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Then he shall recite the last 10 verses of Surah Ali Imran, starting with إِنَّ فِي اخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. Then he may go for his urination or the like. Then if he entering the toilet, he should read one dua, that is بسم الله اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الخبث والخبائث. Then after coming out, he should recite or read one dua, that is أفرانك or أفرانك الحمد لله الذي ذهب عني العذى وعافاني and الحمد لله الذي أذهب عني ما الحمد لله الذي أذهب عني ما يؤذيني وأمسك عني ما ينفعني. And then now we shall see. صحيح البخاري كتاب الوضوء under that كتاب باب حمل العنزة مع الماء في الاستنجاء. حديث نمبر 154 of صحيح البخاري. There it says you should clean the private parts after urination. After urination, we should clean our private parts. This is from the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You see, so many people, even in the way, roadsides, they will be littering or they will be urinating just like animals, and or in the public toilets too. They will be urinating, then with without washing the private parts, they will be going out. Okay. Some people used to clean the toilets, but they will not clean their private parts. Okay. But a Muslim should wash his private parts after urination and defecation. Okay. With water. Not only after defecation, but also after urination. Even if it is only urination, after urination, he should wash his private parts. It is sunnat. It is sunnah means it is from the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is obligatory upon all of us. Okay. Then the bab's name is Babu Hamlil Anazati Ma'al Ma'i Fil Istinja. To carry an anaza, a spearheaded stick, is called anaza, ayn, along with water for washing the private parts after answering the call of nature. One hadith. This hadith is reported by Anas bin Malik. He says, Kana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yadukhulu al-khala'a fa'ahmilu ana wa'ulamun idawatan min ma'u wa anazatan yastanji bil ma'u. No. Anas bin Malik reports, I and one guy, used to carry water in a case, in a vessel, and a stick bearing a spear, kundamulla oru stick. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to toilet, went to the toilet or for urination or for answering the call of nature. So whenever as Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to answer the call of nature, I along with another boy used to carry a tumbler full of water and a stick with a spear. Okay, this is the hadith. Now the sharah, the explanation given in Fathul Bari by Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani. There it says, كَانَ إِذَا, in one report, كَانَ إِذَا خَرَجَ لِحَاجَتِهِ وَلِقَرِيَةِ حَمْلِ الْحَنَزَةِ مَعَ الْمَاءِ فَإِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ إِلَيْهَا إِنَّمَا تَكُونُ حَيْثُ لَا سُتْرَةَ عَلَيْهَا غَيْرَهَا. Now, so in one report we see, كَانَ إِذَا خَرَجَ لِحَاجَتِهِ, whenever Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam intended to go into privy, then we used to carry a spear headed stick and a vessel carrying water. Water is for what purpose? For the washing of the Prophet, his private parts after urination. Okay. And this anaza, why this anaza or spear-headed stick was brought? Or why did they took a spear-headed stick with them when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to toilet? We said toilet, or when it was in open place. Okay, then why? There are some observations regarding this. That is, we know the water is for cleaning. The water was for cleaning purpose. But why this anaza or spear-headed stick was used? For what purpose? And there are some discussions. Okay. So some people observe that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took the spear or stick as a cover or a sutra to hide himself when he go into pray, when he answered the call of nature, when he urinated or like that. Okay. So some people say like that, and there are other observations too in this regard, because لِأَنَّ ضَوَامِدَ سُطْرَةِ فِي هَذَا مَا يَسْتُرُ الْأَسَافِلَ وَالْعَنَزَةُ لَيْسَتِ كَذَلِكَ نعم يحتمل إن أن يركزها أمامه ويضع عليها الثوب الساترة أو يركزها بجنبه لتكون إشارة إلى منع من يروم المرور بقربه أو تحمل لنبش الأرض الصلبة أو لمنع ما يغرض من هوام الأرض لكونه صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يبعد عند قضاء الحاجة أو تحمل لأنه كان إذا استنجى تفضأ ويتوضأ صلى وهذا أظهر الأوجه وسيأتي التبويب على الأنزة في سترة المصلي في الصلاة. No. So why this stick was used? For what purpose? There are discussions. Some observe that it was used as a sutra, as a covering to hide himself from others when he is going to pray. Okay. That is one view. But the view against it is that, or the objection raised against is that when one go to privy or urination or defecation, one should cover the lower part, mainly the lower part. So the person will be sitting. Okay, then one should cover the lower part, that is the most important. Okay, then a spear or a stick can't cover the lower part at all. Okay? A spear or a stick can't cover. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam might have used the stick as follows. That is, he might have either arranged his dress or clothes above the or upon the stick. He might have arranged his clothes upon the stick to hide himself from others. So it was open place. Okay, then in travel and all like that. Then your modern toilets, then okay, see, then also as an indication to prevent others from coming. The stick, he might have used as an indication for others not to come. That he is doing urination there. So, hence, others will be going away, not coming near. So, as an indication, as a sign, he might have used the stick like that. Also, there is another chance that he might have used the stick to keep the small worms away from the place. So, in deserts, in open place, he used to go to some faraway places for his urination from among the people. He will keep away, okay, when he wanted to urinate. Then there is chance in the floor, in the soil, there will be some small worms like that. So, to keep them away, he might have used the stick. Got the point? Okay, to keep the worms, small worms, away. Then, another view is that, as he used to take wudu soon after going into privy. So, soon after going into privy or urination. So, because of urination, one's wudu will be cut off. Okay. Then he has to take another wudu. So, every time Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam will have wudu. Okay. He will be pure always. Okay. So, whenever he urinated, then soon after he would take wudu. And soon after taking wudu, he would offer two rak'ah salah. Okay. Then for salah in open place, there should be a sutra. There should be a covering, a barrier. So in open place, he might have used that stick as a sutra for the salah. Okay. Got it? Got. واستدل البخاري بهذا الحديث على غسل البول كما سيأتي وفيه جواز استخدام الأحرار خصوصا إذا أرصدوا لذلك ليحصل لهم التمرن على التواضع وفيه أن في خدمة العالم شرفا للمتعلم لكون أبي الدرداء مدح ابن مسعود بذلك. No, بخاري, إمام بخاري has taken proof from this hadith that one should use water for washing the private parts after urination. Okay. So this hadith points to that fact. Okay. Then also there is the permissibility of taking the service of others, not slave ones. Not only slave ones, slaves, free persons. Then here we see Anas radiallahu anhu and another boy took the took the stick and water for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So we have seen. So he took the service of those two people. Okay. So it is permissible to take the service of the people if they are ready for that. So they voluntarily did that. Okay. They voluntarily served Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Okay. Then it will help for training in humbleness and humility. Okay. Vinayam padikkan. So humbleness padikkan vendi. Idu upakarikkum. Then tamarrunu. Training. Ala tawadhu. Humbleness or humility. And وفي أن في خدمة العالم شرفا للمتعلم. Also there is one point, that is, for a student, serving his teacher is a dignity, actually. Okay, so Anas ibn Malik, a student of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So for a student, for a pupil, serving his teacher is a dignity. Okay, it is a sharaf. It is a dignity. Okay. It increases his rank. Who's the people? The student's rank is increased. Okay. then. And Abu Darda praised Ibn Mas'ud for that. It is for serving the teachers. Then no, we shall see another hadith or some more hadith regarding this. Sunan Abi Dawud, hadith number 43, Kitab Tuhara, Bab fil Istinja'i bil Ma. That also is reported by Anas ibn Malik. And Anas ibn Malik and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dakhala ha'itan wa ma'ahu ulaman ma'ahu mi'latan wa huwa as'aruna fawada'aha inda sidrati faqala hajatahu fakharaja alayna wa qad istanja bil ma'. No. Anas ibn Malik reports. Suddenly Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once entered a park. Okay? A park. Then ha'it, a park. Then wa ma'ahu ulam. And accompanied him was a boy, Ula. Mahu Milatun. And there was a vessel carrying water with this boy. Okay. As'aruna. And that boy was the smallest among us. Smallest boy among us. Wawalaha in the Sidra. Then that boy placed that vessel carrying water near the low tree. There was a sidra. There was a tree in that park. So he placed that vessel containing water in that under the tree. Okay. Okay. Then faqala hajatahu. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam urinated, or he answered the call of nature. Fakharaja alaina. Then he went out or came to us. فَقَدْ اسْتَنْجَى بِالْمَاءِ. And he had used the water to clean his private parts. Okay. So there, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used water to clean the private parts after urination. Okay. No. Hadith number 44 in Sunan Abu Dawud itself. Okay. And Abi Huraira, Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu reports this hadith. And in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, nazalat hadhihi al-ayatu fi ahli Quba. Fihi rijali yuhibbuna an yatatuharu. Qal Abu Huraira, kanu yastanjuna bil-maa, fanazalat fihim hadhihi al-ayah. Abu Huraira reports from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said, nazalat hadhihi al-ayah. This ayat, this verse from Holy Quran, fi ahli Quba, it is revealed in the case of Quba, the people of Quba. Quba, you know, Quba, Masjid Quba. Then the hadith, the verse is like this: fihi rijalin yuhibbuna an yatatahharu. There are men who فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ. There were men, or within it, within that masjid, the Masjid Quba, there are men who love to purify. Here, purifying with water. So those people of Quba were purifying with water, okay, after urination. So Allah revealed verses regarding them, and then he used these words, fihi rijalun, there are people in it, in that Masjid Quba. Then yuhibbuna, they love, ay yatataharu, to be purified, or to purify. Okay. Purify, you know, clean, to purify. Now the verse comes in, the verse in this hadith, فِيهِ رِجَالٌ يُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَتَطَهَّرُوا. That is a part of a verse. Okay. In Surah At-Tawbah, verse number 108. So, to understand the point in detail, we should read the previous verse also. So verse number 107 and 108. Just we shall check. Surah At-Tawbah. Surah At-Tawbah. Verse number 107. Take.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والذين اتخذوا مسجدا ضرارا وكفرا وتفريقا بين المؤمنين وإرصادا لمن حارب الله ورسوله من قبل وليحلفن إن أردنا إلا الحسنى والله يشهد إنهم لكاذبون.
And there are those hypocrites who took for themselves a masjid for causing harm and disbelief and division among the believers and as a station for whoever had warred against Allah, who fought against Allah and His Messenger before. And they will surely swear, we intended only the best. And Allah testifies that indeed they are the liars. They are telling lies. Okay. So here, regarding Masjidul Dirar, that is Masjidul Dirar in Quran, it is said. Okay. Masjidul Dirar. Masjid which caused harm. Usually masjid caused benefits. Masjid caused benefits, not harm. Here, harm. Masjidul Dirar. So that masjid was built by a munafiq, a hypocrite, to deviate the Muslims, to create divisions among the Muslims during the time of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Okay. Then when he went to Tabuk, this munafiq and his followers built a masjid. Then he invited Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to inaugurate the masjid, to start prayer in that masjid. But actually Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't know for what purpose that masjid was built by these hypocrites. Okay. He thought it is a masjid. Then actually he said inshallah. But Jibreel came and gave the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it is Masjidul Dirar. This Masjidul Dirar. You should not pray in that masjid built by that munafiq. Okay. They built it to disintegrate Muslims, okay, to create problems, to use it as a station to spy over Muslims, like that. Okay, that information was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet through Wahy. Okay, then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't go there to perform salah, to inaugurate the masjid. Okay, that is in the next verse.
لا تقم فيه أبدا لمسجد أسس على التقوى من أول يوم أحق أن تقوم فيه فيه رجال يحبون أن يتطهروا والله يحب المطهرين لا تقم فيه أبدا.
You should not pray there forever. You should never pray in that masjid. That masjid built by munafiq. Okay. One of the leaders of Munafiq. Okay. He was plotting against Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his companions with the help of Munafiqeen from the Muslims. Munafiqeen, externally they are Muslims. Only if Allah gave information, then only Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam would recognize them. Okay. Then. La masjidun usisa ala taqwa. No, another masjid. A masjid founded on righteousness, that is taqwa, built on taqwa, that is better. Min awwal yawmin, the first day, ahaqqu an taquma fi, that is more worthy to pray. That is Masjid Quba, that is worthy to pray. So you should offer prayer there only. When you are in Quba, you should pray in Masjid Quba, not in the Masjid al-Dirar built by
Munafiq.
Then فيه رجال يحبون أن يطهروا. And there in that Masjid Quba there are men who love to be purified, who loves to purify. والله يحب المطهرين. And Allah allows those who are mutahhirin, or those who purify themselves. So those who clean themselves, those who purify both internally and externally. Okay? Purification is there, both internally, internal purification, hearts, from masviyat, from dhunub, from sins, and external purification with water. Okay? Got it? Then. Now, another hadith. Sahih Muslim, hadith number 517. Kitab al-Tahara, Bab al-Istinja bil Ma'i min al-Tabarruz, cleaning oneself with water after defecating. That also a similar hadith from Anas ibn Malik that we are not going to repeat. Now, Jami al-Turmudi, hadith number 16, Bab al-Istinja bil Hijara, using stone for istinja. So, even if there is no water, we can use what? Stones for the purpose. Then the stones will clear stones or clean. Stones can be used for the purpose to absorb the urine. Okay, to absorb the urine. And for cleaning the after defecation too. If there is no water, then we can use such things only. That is, things such as stones. Okay, which will absorb the humidity or the water. Okay. And in this hadith, Abdullah ibn Yazid reports this hadith. Qala, he said, Qila li Salman. To Salman it was asked, or some people asked Salman, Qad allamakum nabikum sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kulla shayin hatta al-khra'ata. Qala Salman, أجل نهانا أن نستقبل القبلة بغائط أو بول وأن نستنجي باليمين أو أن يستنجي أحدنا بأقل من ثلاثة أحجار أو أن نستنجي برجيع أو بأضل. No. عبد الرحمن بن يزيد. Salman was asked by some people, Your prophet taught you about everything. Everything is taught by your prophet. Some people asked Salman, Sahabi, okay? Your prophet taught you everything. Hatta al-khira'ata, even defecating, even urinating, even what to do in the toilet, how to use the toilet. Even such things are taught by your teacher, your prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then we are surprised, we are astonished to see this. Okay. Then Salman said, Ajal, yes, Nahana, he prohibited us. What? An nastaqbil al-qiblata bighaitin aw bawl. When we urinate or defecate, we should not face the qibla. So he prohibited that. Then, wa an nastanjiya bil yamin. We should not use our right hand. Using right hands is prohibited. Means we should not use the right hand. Okay. We should use our left hand. Okay. أو أن يستنجي أحدنا بأقل من ثلاثة أحجار. And if we use the stones for cleaning, then we should use at least three parts of a bigger stone. Okay. Then aw an nastanji bi raji'in aw bi admin. Or we should not use, that is, we should not use raji' or alum. Raji' means rows, that is dung, cow dung, chanagam, for the purpose of cleaning. Cow dung based to clean the amatla. Cow dung itself is impurity or najas. Or alum or bone. Bone should not be used to clean the private parts. Okay. Now hadith number 19. Babu ma ja'a fil istinja'i bil ma'. What has been reported about istinja with water? So istinja means cleaning after urination. Okay, cleaning after urination or defecation is called a istinjab. Istinjab. This hadith is reported by Aisha radiallahu anha. And Aisha qalat, murna azwajakunna an yastatibu bil ma' fa inni astahyihim fa inna rasulallahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yaf'aluhu. Then Aisha radiallahu anha reports this hadith, the wife of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Qalat, she said, murna azwajakun. Amara ya umur umur. Amara ya umuru u umur. U umur. The sul is u umur. Then it is mur. Okay. Two hamza deleted. Okay. Then amara ya umuru mur. Mur mura muru mur. You should order. You should direct. You should command like that. Here direct. You should direct. Murna, mur, mura, muru, muri, mura, murna, mur, mura, muru, muri, mura, murna, umur, umura, umuru, muri, umura, umurna. Then it is mur, mura, muru, muri, mura, murna, murna for the ladies. Okay, more ladies. Okay, more than two. Murna azwajakunna. So Aisha radiallahu anha was addressing some group of ladies. Okay, so then she said, murna azwajakunna. You should direct your husbands. You should direct your husbands. Azwajakunna. You should direct your husbands. An yastatibu bil ma'u. To clean their private parts with water. To clean their private parts with water. Fa inni astahyihim. Because I am shy. I am too shy to say to them directly. I am a lady. So, I am shy to, I am too shy to say to them directly. So, you should, so Aisha radiallahu anha asking the ladies to tell their husbands to clean their private parts after urination. Okay. So, I am too shy to say them direct. So Aisha radiallahu anha used to take classes for the men, Sahaba, including men and women. Okay. Many Sahaba learned from Aisha radiallahu anha. So this type of things, if I say to them directly, I am too shy to say to them. So you should say to them. Okay. You should direct them. Then فإني أستحييهم فإن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم certainly رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يفعله. He used to do that. Means he used to clean his private parts after urination. Okay. So you also should direct your husbands to do the same. Okay. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaykum as-salam.